dear students, today we will study about the edible parts of the plants. We eat different parts. In some plant we eat the seeds. In other example are mustard, then cereals like rice, then lentils like pea and dal. In some plants we eat the leaves, like in case of mustard, coriander, then cauliflower. Okay, so these plants we are eating the leaves. You can see that in mustard plant we are eating both the leaves and the seeds. In some plants we eat the flowers also, like marigold, pumpkin, saffron. Okay, now saffron is called kesar. In other plants we eat the fruits like mango and apple. Okay, some plants we eat the stems, like in case of potato, ginger, onion. Now ginger, it looks like a root but it is actually a stem. Onion also is a stem. Below the onion stem you can see small roots arising. In onion we also eat the leaves. So I can write here onion also, example of leafy parts that we eat. Then in some plants we eat the roots, like in case of radish and carrot. First activity 5. In this activity what you have to do, you have to take some moong. Moong is lentil, dal. Okay, it is available in your home very easily. It is available. So you have to make sprouted moong. You have to make sprouted moong from the raw moong dal. What you have to do for that, you have to take moong dal or chana dal. Okay, then you have to soak it in water overnight. Take a pot of water, soak the seeds in the water and keep it overnight. Then you have to take the seeds out and put in a damp cloth and cover it. Leave it again for one day. Next day you will see that small roots are coming out of the seed. Okay, from the seed small roots are coming out. These are called radicals. So this thing, the whole thing is called a sprout. The sprout is very good for health. It can be used as salad or for cooking purpose also. Do you know where honey comes from or how it is produced? Now honey comes from the nectar of the flower. Okay, in the flower, inside the flower there is a sweet liquid that is called nectar. The bee will come and it will drink the nectar and take the nectar and fill it inside the beehives. The beehives are honeycomb like structure. It is made by the honeybee with the help of wax. Okay, and inside the beehive the honeybee will fill the honey for its baby bees to have the this honey. Okay, then when we need the honey we will let the honeybee fly away and then we can collect the honey and keep it in the jar. The honey is very good for cold and cough. It is a good antibiotic. It is a natural antibiotic. So we should take honey. It's very good for health also. Now we come to the conclusion of the chapter. In this chapter, food, where does it come from? We have learned that what is food? What are the sources? What is food? What are the sources of food? So what are the sources? The sources of food are plants and animals. Then third, we have studied what are the edible parts of the plant. We different parts of the plant like seed, leaf, stem, then flower and root. Then we have studied about how to make the sprout of moong and how do you get the honey from. We also studied about herbivore, carnivore and omnivore. So final conclusion for this chapter is that there are a lot of variation of food eaten in different regions of the India. The main source of our foods are plants and animals. Animals which eat only plants are called herbivore. Animals which eat only animals are called carnivore. Animals which eat both plants and animals are called omnivore. It is very difficult to grow food and everybody cannot get food. So, dear students, keep this in mind and don't waste food. Whatever food your parents are giving you, providing you, you have to eat all the food. Don't take extra food in your plates and don't waste the food. Thank you.